and he usually attends all my programs. And boys and girls, are you listening to Mrs. Feeney?
Yes.
Okay, so you have to listen. And he goes, he calls me by my first name, and he goes, well, what time is the program? And I said, it's 9:30 in the morning. He goes, oh man, you know me. I'm older now, and I stay up late till 2 o'clock in the morning, and I don't get to get up until 12 o'clock. I said, Dad, but this program's for you. And he was laughing. He goes, I'll pass on this one, but I promise I'll make the next one. But he usually attends all my programs, but I would like to dedicate this program to my father as well. At this time, I would like everybody to stand up.
The United States of America, and to the Republic for which they stand, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Our nation histories, our sons and daughters, the age of the call to defend our country.
World War II, Vietnam War, Gulf War, and the Iraqi Freedom Operation as well. They apply to today's active service members and tomorrow's veterans who are hoping to make a peace throughout the world.
Who has given us the freedom to demonstrate.
It was the
whose coffin was draped by the flag.
Thank you. very unique job in the Army, one of which provided me with the opportunity to work with just about every unit or service member from just about every branch of the service. And I can say without a doubt that the spirit and essence of every veteran and old war horse that went before me occupies just about every installation, hallway, barracks, or ship in the Armed Forces. So to those of you old war horses that served before me, it was an honor to be in your shadow. To some of you still in uniform and still serving, thank you for picking up the guidon and running with it. Ms. Feeney asked me to tell a quick story, and the first thing that popped into my mind that I thought the children would enjoy was way back in 2002, February I think it was, I ended up getting some open-ended orders to go down to Fort Polk and train some units of Rangers heading off to Afghanistan. The very last night before leaving, I had all my equipment laid out, and I'm trying to pack everything, including some uniforms. And my son, who was 2 years old at the time, had just gotten one of those little bouncy balls. It cost 50 cents in the little machines there by the supermarket doors. And kept nagging me, wanted to play with the bouncy ball. And after telling him no about 3 or 4 times, sure enough, I ended up getting that nice little pouty voice, or pouty look that only a 2-year-old can give. And that no parent can deny, of course. So we decided we were going to play with the bouncy ball at that, and sure enough, a half hour later, he lost interest in the bouncy ball, and bath time, hugs and kisses and prayers, later he was fast asleep. And of course, I was gone at that point in time before sun up. About a week or so later, I'm out in the training area at Fort Polk. Put on one of my spare uniforms, and throughout the whole day there was something in the one pocket that kept just annoying me, was bugging me, rubbing the wrong way every time I sat down and moved. And after about 4 or 5 hours of this, I reached into my pocket to figure out what was that, and sure enough, it was the bouncy ball. And all I could do was, well, that's my son. So I put it back in there and I let it annoy me for the rest of the time that I was gone, and sure enough, 4 months later, I come home, ask him why he... Well, that's not for us. Sure enough, when I asked him about it, he said, well, I wanted something for you to play with. So to this day, it is in the glove box of my Jeep. And every time I'm taking a right-hand or left-hand turn, you can hear that thing rolling across the back, bouncing away. Annoying my wife every time, and she's like, what is that? That's Caleb the bouncy ball. So we all take a little piece of our family with us no matter where we go, and that was the one story I wanted to share with you. Thank you very much for showing me. Thank you guys. You did a great job.
America struggled in this cruel deal. Yet this is tragedy. We pass on the community and brotherhood.
Oh, yeah. find peace and to be there. These are the people that represent you and me. They stood up strongly, united as one, and they kept the fighting until they...
And all of us have fallen and lost our life in war, we pray for each one and lift our souls in the world.
Above God's hand, they watch over our nation and give us strength to triumph over others with strong anticipation.
The bravest man I know is a man I've never met.